NASA's Hubble Space Telescope launched on April 24, 1990, and it's been hard at work ever since, studying the cosmos like no other observatory in human history. Several times in its journey, astronomers have called upon Hubble to study a single spot in the sky for weeks at a time, staring as far as it can, almost to the edge of the observable universe. These are the deep fields, including the most recent Hubble Extreme Deep Field. Now, all of these data have been mashed together into a single image, spanning more than 250 days of observations. It's called the Hubble Legacy Field. It's full of galaxies. After the launch of Hubble, NASA and ESA realized that they had a big problem with the telescope's optics, one that could only be repaired by astronauts physically visiting and fixing the telescope. Astronauts arrived in December 1993 with new instruments and the equipment that it would take to fix the flaw. Once the mission was complete, astronomers took some test images of an empty region of the sky to calibrate the telescope's new optics. What looked like empty space to other telescopes was revealed to be filled with galaxies in the eyes of Hubble. In 1996, Hubble performed its first deep field survey, staring at a region of the sky near the constellation Ursa Major for more than 100 hours over 10 consecutive days, gathering 342 separate exposures. They chose this region because it's high above the Milky Way and it's as empty as possible of foreground stars. The field was tiny. Imagine the size of a dime, located 23 meters or 75 feet away. In this single image, Hubble turned up almost 3,000 galaxies, most of which had never been seen before. Galaxies which were 4 billion times fainter than can be seen by the human eye. And in this image, astronomers saw galaxies 10 billion years old, at a time when the universe was less than a third of its current age. It was like using a time machine to go back to the early universe to see what it looked like near the beginning of time itself. Over the next few years, Hubble received several upgrades. Astronauts flew back to the aging telescope to fix its failing gyros and install additional instruments. On March 1, 2002, astronauts arrived to install its most sensitive instrument yet, the Advanced Camera for Surveys. This was a modern astronomical CCD camera that was 10 times more sensitive than the previous camera, allowing Hubble to look back even farther into space and further back in time. It was time to do another deep field. In 2004, NASA and ESA released the Hubble Ultra Deep Field, another marathon observing session that took advantage of the newly installed Advanced Camera for Surveys. This time, Hubble stared into a tiny region in the constellation Fornax for 1 million seconds, or 11 and a half days. In this one image, a region that ground-based telescopes find mostly empty, Hubble saw 10,000 galaxies. Young galaxies, old galaxies, and galaxies smashing into each other. Some were seen at a time 13 billion light-years ago, less than a billion years after the Big Bang itself. Hubble then viewed these same regions in infrared using its Wide Field Camera 3, finding objects that were even more distant, just 450 million years after the Big Bang. In 2012, astronomers released the Extreme Hubble Deep Field. This wasn't a new set of observations, but a combination of all the data Hubble had captured in the Fornax region. The overlapping observations took up a smaller part of the sky, containing only 5,500 galaxies, but with more sensitivity. The faintest are 1/10 billionth the brightness of what the human eye can see. And finally, this week, NASA and ESA announced their latest work from the telescope, the Hubble Legacy Field, 265,000 galaxies in one picture. And we'll get to that in a second, but first I'd like to thank some special patrons who have supported me for over 5 years. Romaine, Fred Manzella, Chris Copabianco, Ron Volkman, Todd Sanders, and the rest of our 796 patrons for their generous support. They contribute so that you can see these videos and we can make them freely available to anyone who wants to learn about space. Join our community at patreon.com/universetoday and get in on the action. Okay, I'll admit, this video was mostly just me being nostalgic about the Hubble Deep Field pictures, but I promised news. Let's get into it. Last week, we got to see the newest image from the Deep Field Survey. It's called the Hubble Legacy Field, and it's made up of 16 years of Hubble observations. This image is a mosaic made up of 7,500 individual exposures and contains 265,000 galaxies stretching back to 13.3 billion years ago, just 500 million years after the Big Bang. The raw data in the image covers wavelengths from infrared through visible to ultraviolet, revealing every stage of galaxy formation from the earliest proto-galaxies to the more recent mature galaxies. Many are the result of collisions between galaxies and even galaxy clusters in the early universe, stirring up regions of furious star formation. The photo is much wider than previous surveys, covering a region of the sky about as big as the full moon, a region that encompasses the original extreme deep field, and much more. All in all, Hubble has spent 250 days observing this one region of the sky, more time than anywhere else it's looked. 265,000 galaxies in one picture. Mind blown. Of course, their work isn't done. A second set of images are in the works, which will be made up of more than 5,200 additional exposures. And the team is planning to combine these with surveys taken by NASA's other great observatories, Spitzer and Chandra, to add longer wavelength infrared and high energy X-rays to the image. Future telescopes will add on to this legacy, looking deeper and surveying other wavelengths. The most exciting contributor will of course be the James Webb Space Telescope, due for launch on March 30th, 2021. With more than six times the collecting area, James Webb will peer back to the earliest moments in the universe and see the first stars and galaxies forming in the cosmos. It'll watch those early galaxies crashing into each other to form larger and larger structures. Oh, and not to mention watching the birth of stars and the planets orbiting around them. But I'm sure there will be a James Webb Deep Field. I can't wait to see it. What do you think? Let me know your thoughts in the comments. Once a week, I gather up all my space news into a single email newsletter and send it out. It's got pictures, brief highlights about the story, and links so that you can find out more. Go to universetoday.com/newsletter to sign up. Did you know that all of my videos are also available in a handy audio podcast format so that you can have the latest episodes show up right on your audio device? Go to universetoday.com/audio or search for Universe Today on iTunes, Spotify, or wherever you get your podcasts, and I'll put a link in the show notes. And finally, here's a playlist.